Good evening. I'm Lalit Palegama, Chairman of Sweden Section Committee. This is a very special this occasion because due to two reasons. One is as my duties introduce our speaker, Engineer U.S. Karunaretne. The reasons one is many of us know who is U.S. As a very prominent engineer in the country, but the specialties like these kind of things. Not only this, as I know, he has done some rammed earth construction, soil stabilize bricks, and a lot of things he has done in the past few years, and he has served many projects in the country, and I think 22 years more than 20 experience in CECB. That is the first reason. Second one is very special for me actually, because I came to Colombo before 15 years ago. The first person I met in the industry, US, actually he was my boss. So that guidance was very helpful for me. Today I'm in very good position, I think. So I worked with him 4 years, but after that I decided to resign from the CECB. Then I requested from him I need to resign. He's accepted. He said, yes, your decision is correct. Still I can remember that one. So still I'm getting his guidance for my not only the professional things, a lot of in matters I'm going to him discuss and get guidance. So those are the two reasons, and that was the things from my heart. Official, I need to read this his profile. U.S. Karu graduated from University of Moratuwa in the field of civil engineering in 1991. He is fellow of Institute of Engineers Sri Lanka, a corporate member of Society of Structural Engineers Sri Lanka, a member of Association of Consulting Engineers Sri Lanka, and also an international professional engineer. At present, he is the chief executive officer of the Central Engineering Services Private Limited, the construction arm of CECB, and also holds a post of manager training, research and development. U.S. Karu has been able to possess a vast experience and knowledge by being involved in many infrastructure projects in various capacities during the past 25 years. I'm going to invite him to deliver his lecture about this design and construction of mobile portal.
හැමදාම පටන් ගන්න විදිහට ආයිබෝන් කියලා පටන් ගන්නවා. This is a unique presentation in the sense that this is not a building. You can't say that this is a building. This is a different type of project. When I spoke to Mr. Palligama, he said, why not to present this? You know that we did a couple of years back. So he insisted me, why not to present this? That is why that I am here, due to his request. Is this a theater? Is this a theater? This hall? This is not a theater. This is a lecture hall. So what is the difference between a theater and a lecture hall? There must be a difference. So you should know from the beginning, even though that it is not the duty of engineer, you can't say that it is not the duty of engineer, it is the duty of architect. No one can argue like that. For a project like this, you should know, you should study what are the types of theaters, what are the theaters. So this is where that I am asking. So do you know what is a theater? We did this work while we were on our duty. So this is a on the job research and development work. So there is a I think award also in ISL for this kind of work. but we have never applied for that. Types of theatres, you should know what are the types of theatres. The proscenium theatre, in English it is called proscenium theatre, meaning stage is on one side and the audience is on the other side. It is just opposite. Okay, so the proscenium theatre is what we usually think as theatres. Lumbiniya, Kiwat, that is same, but not Maharagama Youth Centre. It is not that. Maharagama Youth Centre belongs to this stage surrounded by audience on three sides. Those who have visited, Youth Centre, even Navarangal, I suppose it is a trust theatre where the stage is there, audience is there, audience is there, and audience is there. Okay, so this is called trust theatre. And the other type is arena theatre. This is a central stage surrounded by audience on all sides. So the audience and the cast, you know, they become part and parcel while they are playing. So this is more and it is more liked by the people. It is not this proscenium, because we don't have such experience. That is why people go and see the proscenium. We'll go to this video first. The purpose of building this Janakaraliya mobile theatre, according to the client requirements, so this was, this concept came in around 2005, before the war. So this one unique feature in the dramas played in this theatre is, it is bilingual. That is meaning, a drama is played in Sinhala and next time the drama, same drama is played in Tamil. When Tamil dramas are played, it is converted to Sinhala language and played. So the cast is both Tamil guys and Sinhala guys. So through that, H.A. Pereira, and that was the vision of these people, these master people, even Parakramaniriyal, they wanted to have the bridge. They wanted to, bridge the gap between the Sinhala and Tamil community, taking drama to the village. So it is a very good purpose, to take the drama to the village level. You know that village people, they don't have any facility to watch a drama. So they have that also, the purpose. So these things, as an engineer, I should understand. We did the structural design also, but and the project management. But the thing is, as designers, in nowadays, we always say that it should be an integrated design, meaning everyone should understand the other parties, you know, the profession. Then only you can get a, you know, better design. So this is why that we should understand what is the purpose of this. To identify and nurture the village drama culture. There are various cultures developed in villages, and they want to take these cultures out from these villages and take to the city. To educate children on drama. That is also another purpose of having this mobile theater. The client and the budget, you know, the client is USA, they funded the project. Janakaraliya is the owner of the project. The budget is, you won't believe, Sri Lankan rupees 5 million. But I have put here Lankan rupees 50 million and cut this. The reason is, there is another private company who quoted for the same theater 50 million at that time with a different material, roofing material. Roofing material is different. See the difference, huh? See the difference, 5 million versus 50 million. But with a different roofing material, I have to accept it. We will discuss it later. And the execution type is design and build. So the design and the build, all components are done by us, CECB, at that time. So the client's requirements, so this is very stringent. In my lifetime, I didn't have this kind of, you know, requirement by a client. Be capable of accommodating 500 people, because they are dramatists. They want people. They want 500 people to be accommodated there. So everything will be looked after by the architect at the beginning. But he alone can't do this. He need our assistance also, because this is not a normal building. Okay. Be capable of transporting, using, if Mahinda can remember, he is the one who was right behind me, Mr. Mahinda Jayakodi, veteran engineering assistant, capable of doing many things. So he was behind me with this project right throughout. Be capable of transport using two lorry loads. That is one condition that he put. Okay. And maximum unloading and erection time, again 2 days. Okay. So these are the client's requirements. Huh? Maximum dismantling and loading time. Dismantle and loading to the lorry. It is 2 days. Because they take to one village or one city, and there they stay about 2 to 3 weeks, sometimes 1 month. That is how it goes. Okay. Performance should not be hampered by rain and sun, obviously. Theatre should be assembled as arena type. This is where they came up with the word arena. So at that time only we also knew what is arena. So we went and study about theatre types. So this is the first architectural design sketch did by the veteran architect Udula Bandara Ausadami. He was the architect behind the scene. He did this with calculations. You know that there are norms for an office building. There are so much of people per square meter. Likewise, that he has put a just a sketch. Okay, so this is so these things are, these are the seatings. He has, seat, terraced seats, meaning the seats are going like that. Terraced seats, okay. This is the original sketch from him. 140 seats either side, 70-70 on the other sides, and every together it comes to around 500, okay. So this was a cross section, even though that we didn't really build this one, but this is how the architectural, that architects, they begin with one sketch, but the final, that is how that profession goes like that. We have to accept it. You can't say as engineering it should be the same. No, it is with the design it goes, and this is a cross section of that. Here, the important points is, about 500 people are going to stay there. So think about You know, these things are very, you know, required, but not only by a structural engineer, every person should think this. 500 people, how much of energy, how much of heat generated inside? So there must be good ventilation. So he has addressed this issue. Air is taken out from the top. So this is a side view. He has put this sketch to me and Parakrama Niriyalle at that time, and we didn't know what is going to be, because this was we haven't seen anything. This is only a sketch. Okay. So as engineers, then we start thinking what are the components of this structure. You know, these junior engineers, those who are present here, this is how a design is evolved. And you come to an actual figure. You know, main components of the theater, central frame structure, because that he has given earlier, he has given with that, you can think that there must be some kind of he has put these masts. So that means that there must be some kind of central supports. When you look at the other drawings, you can main components of the theater, center frame structure, two end coverings, stage, these are the main things that we identified, seating arrangement, how the seats are to be provided, roof covering is again a challenge. So layout plan, this was the engineer's drawing, that was the architect's the sketch, and this is our drawing. So these are the stage and the seating arrangements are there. The changing rooms have to be provided. This is going to be a theater, okay? And storage, some kind of a storage, costume room, then control room for sound and light. All are provided like a proscenium theater. So center frame structure, of course, with these sketches. And those who are little bit of familiar with structural engineering know the importance of, I say, A-frame. Our boss always say about Mr. Gamini Silla regarding A-frame. A-frame is a most stable form of structure. Appears triangular. A-frame. So these concepts that we came into our mind. And you can see, so we believed in these basic structural things that we knew, not that finite element or everything. So we believed ourselves, self-reliance. So we started thinking about this kind of arrangement. Okay, so based on that, these are the seats provided.
These are the seats provided, and these are the joint details. This is a structural drawing
prepared based on the architect's. So assembling of center frame structure. These pictures show you how this center frame structure is assembled at site. Okay. So this is a first picture. Left side is unloaded stuff from the container. Two lorry loads means either 40 foot container or two numbers of 20 foot containers. So this is, they have purchased 40 foot container. This is a unloaded state. So now they have started
checking out.
It should be completed within 2 days. That was one of the tasks given to us. So all these were now this is the bottom part of the A-frame.
Here the bottom part of the A-frame, you will see that
it facilitates climbing up. So these things came into our mind, and
a person can climb up here.
So these are the bracings. That is the top truss, circular truss. Basically, this is a tension. These structures are called tensile structures. The tension is predominant here. everywhere. Here the assembling of center frame structure, you know, now people are assembling. Here the all the people are the, you know, the cast or the nalu tamai meke okko nalu niliya tamai meke karanne. So they are the people who are behind this. No technical people there to once we, and the other thing that we have given them six sets of scaffolding for the, because this is you have to, you can give more, but the thing is transportability, mobility, you must be very careful about mobility, okay, otherwise you can't meet the stringent conditions. So this is again assembling of all these are artists, you know, the dramatists, they are actors, they do the assembling. The detailing, you know, the detailing, I don't know whether you have heard a famous scientist has called, and even Dr. Kulasinghe, I can still remember, he was whispering this thing, God lives in the detail. That is what Dr. Kulasinghe used to say those days. God lives in the detail. It is not the structural calculations what matters. It is the detail what matters most. Here the success of the project, you know, the mainly because of the, you know, the combined effort put by all of us, not by me. I never say that it is a team effort. All the effort put by people for proper detailing of this project. This is how the curved. You see, then the background structures are coming on. Here, of course, we have ensured a perfect pin joint at the center. Of course, one can ask, I have raised this question at the end, where is the safety? We will answer these questions at the end. Just before I come, I spoke to Mr. Parakranariyala. In fact, I invited him here. He is now in Anuradhapura. And I inquired how many injuries or damages happened to this cast during this. I think he said more than 30 or 40 places already they have visited throughout the island. Japna, Trincomalee, Ampara, Matara, everywhere. So this structure has undergone to several wind conditions. You know that there are three wind zones according to our wind code here. Three wind zones. In northeast the wind is very, very prominent. There also they have erected this and tested. Nothing has happened to this structure. Because of the way that, because of the thinking, original thinking, I will show you how it happened. These are the stages of assembling the main structure. It takes around, I think, about one day. Neda mahinda, samane davasak vidare yanawa ne eka muduweka adjust karaganna eka ilanga davase thamai drama eka pennanna puluwan e. So the once it is finished, then the next step is to put the roofing. As roofing, we have selected here canvas material as the roofing material. There are reasons behind that also. I will explain it once we go to the roofing part. So these are the two end covering structures. Apart from the main structure, there are two end covering parts, okay, because that gives you the additional space for this storage, then for the sound and light equipment storage, like. So this is again the principle is again, that is also, if you see it carefully, it is also a modified A-frame. Like normally a A-frame is like this, now this is a modified A-frame. Still it is a more stable structure, okay. getting the shape also. And when you work with this canvas material or the roofing with fabric, you must make sure that water is not stagnant on the roof. That is the main criteria you must see, otherwise the whole structure will collapse. You must ensure the shapes should be such that the water is not stagnant on the roof. So that is how these shapes derived. So assembling of these, now you can clearly see how this, it is a modified base. In the background they are canter, they are container, 40 foot container is there, background. So assembling of two end covering structures. These are the tension ropes, and for ground anchoring, we have used mild steel 16 millimeter diameter mild steel bars for ground anchoring, and these are tension ropes, and the cloth is under tension. So that is why we call that this kind of structures are tensile structures. Basically, predominantly all these forces in the ropes and everything is tension. This is how the stage is constructed, fabricated using box iron framework. When you build this kind of structure, this is not a theater, this is a lecture hall. So there won't be any inertia forces acting on. Inertia forces in the sense that in a theater, people come and they come and hit the stage like this. So that should be taken into your mind. The construction of this and stage is two different, the bracing is completely different. We have experience, we have constructed more than 20 auditoriums. We know how the bracing has to be done in an auditorium stage. That is a completely different scenario than a lecture hall stage. ...25 millimeter thick plywood sheets were used as stage timber deck. Again, it is easy to carry, a single plywood sheet. Engineering principle here is control of deflection. When people are doing that, it should not be deflected, and lateral sway of the stage. This is the principle behind. So this is how the you can't see the underneath bearing plates, and this is about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six plywood sheets mean 12 by 16 foot stage, 12 by 16, that is enough for them, 12 foot by 16, 4 meter by 5 meter or 5.5, like. This is how the final appearance of the center stage. See the crowd here, this is around 800, even though that it was designed for 500, even 800, from the tickets that you know the people, how many people are there, about 800 people are there. For seating arrangement, scaffolding, we as construction people, we have seen how the scaffolding is loaded, unloaded, taken to a lorry, that there is some kind of a modular arrangement there. So with that vision that we have designed this seating so that you can dismantle to a small element. When you dismantle whole seating, it is a series of small scaffolding sets, like. That is how that it didn't come from the mass or some other thing, but it is the experience or the that is why that every time that engineers should be able to visualize and grasp thing so that we can use it for some other occasion. When it is there properly, you can use it. This is how we did it. Use the knowledge how scaffolding sets are transported in the container. This is why I believe always the designers, before they design, they should do construction. But I don't think that that practice is in Sri Lanka or even in CECB, we can't correct it. People, they start their professions right from the design. Designers, without having this kind of, you know, experience, I don't know how they can detail. Detailing is the problem. You can't detail by looking books, you know, you have to keep it in the mind, otherwise transfer of vertical and lateral loads through adequate supports and bracings, stage. No, the seating, even the seating, even the scaffoldings, you know that there are two, in a scaffolding set, you have two bracings on either side. The same principle we adopted for seating even, because there can be a jerk, you know, that about 500 to 600 people, you know, you must be very careful about the safety of the people, okay? So even though that it is not coming out from the pictures that there is no safety, like it is how the picture shows, but we paid our full attention for the safety of the people. Modular form to facilitate transport and stacking. So this is why, this is what I said, you know, that these are the scaffolding sets, and here of course there are two GI lip channels, and steel metal plank. So GI lip channels, why GI we took, why GI? People want to sit on a, you know, finished surface. So that is why we selected GI, not MS. If MS used, what happens? Due to corrosion, people won't sit on that surface. People need always a clean surface, a cleaner surface. That is why we used GI lip channels for seating. And to keep their foot, steel metal planks were used. That is with green, green or blue color we used. So a person sits here and put this like that. So you know that we went up to that extent. Always, try to appreciate the thinking behind this. That is what I wanted to, you know, in the presentation. How much you need to go for a good detail? How much you need to think? Assembling of seating. This is the seat. Keeping the ventilation gap so that ventilation is also ensured. And this is blue color, you know, scaffolding plates, checkered also. Make sure that there won't be any slip. For slipless movements, scaffolding plates are there. So this is how these people, all are actors and actresses in the group, how they have assembling these scaffolding sets, you know, little small scaffolding sets, ultimately it come to terrace seating, you know, matching the architect's original concept. For seating, GI roof purlins were used with adequate space for ventilation. I mentioned it. For walking paths, blue colored checkered scaffolding boards were used. Checkered surface ensure a slipless walking. See, again, we looked after the safety side as far as possible. Okay. Blue color determines the path of walking. You know, when there are terrace seating, you have to define a path horizontally and vertically as well. So blue color ensure that horizontal parking and the vertical path. So here of course you will see the blue color and the seating clearly. Here you will see the seat and the how the A-frame looks, and you know that even though that it looks as a mess, but it has no effect on the, and the architect approved, and the project was a very successful one. You imagine 50 million versus 5 million, why not they accept? Assembling of seating, here again, how these girls are, you know, they have put, they are put on the blue colored checkered board, you know, otherwise they won't sit if it is not GI, definitely. And the other thing that it naturally you know, direct a person to travel only on the green path or the blue path. Here roof covering, canvas is used as roof covering. Canvas is fixed to steel structure using fabric strips at uniform intervals. Fabric is pre-tensioned by using half inch outer diameter polypropylene ropes. අපි කියන්නේ අර tangus වගේ තියෙන එකකින් තමයි මේක ඇදලා බැන්දේ. ඒ වගේ ටෙන්ෂන් ඔක්කොම අපි හොයාගත්තා. Engineering principle behind the canvas roof covering design is, engineering principle, this is what is required, you know, that before designing you should understand what is the area that I should. This is confusing the wind. Even in high rise buildings, you know, the in wind designs, it is the principle is the confuse the wind always. That is why the structures are going like this. It is to confuse the wind. If there is a structure like this and wind comes and hit, you know, that positive pressures are developed. So you should try to eliminate it by some form of openings or this is I don't have that video clip when in a wind how this you know, the roof covering are going here and like there, and you know, it confuses the wind. So this is the principle. Roof covering with the help of the wind confusing is you know, did with the tension ropes and properly double ground anchors. Testimony in withstanding under high wind is the erection of Janakaraliya mobile theater over many locations in almost all parts of the island, not in the island, even this was taken to India also, I came to know. So this is how these people are, you know, putting these ground anchors and tension the ropes. Selection of roofing fabric, of course, at that time, even now there are any, some other materials are also there. I brought some material. The cheapest one is the cotton or the canvas material. It is about 400 rupees per square foot. Okay, life expectancy 0 to 5 years, it says. PVC or polyester, it is 1200, and the PTFE material, this is what you see at the Dietuena and everywhere, the white colored one, even in Karunaretne airport you will see a tensile structure, that is PTFE material, it is 8000, it is 20 times price at the cotton. So there is no other option than going for cotton. Cotton in the sense the canvas material. And also there are the cleanability, you know, that it is taking from place to place. When dismantling, mud and dirt can be, you know, it can apply on the surface. So you must be very careful in, but when you consider this life expectancy, cost, handling easiness, that PTFE material very difficult to handle, and it is not advisable. They don't advise, you know, for repeated erections. They don't advise. Once it is tension, it is tension. Okay, so this kind of things are very important in selecting this material. And in the light transfer, these are the things, that parameters that we looked into in selecting the material. Reflectivity, fire, of course, yeah, there is a possibility that cotton, but at the expense of the money, how are you going to meet the fire AS 153 dot, you can't do that with the available money. UV resistance, sound resistance, heat conductivity, these things we check, you know, that these are the parameters looked at that time. So colors and the other thing that canvas material, there were only that green color canvas is available at that time. So they used that to identify easily, yellow strip, red strip and blue strip, like, you know, that just to identify what comes to first, second, third, like, you know. And graphics meaning that you can put any paint on the canvas. Okay, that possibility is there. But if you use this PTFE material, you can't do that kind of thing. It's difficult. Even in polyester, it is difficult. So transportability. This canvas is ideal for temporary. That is what we see in this scouting. Yeah, you see this in army, police, navy trucks. You see this canvas material. So for the last 10 years, I think more than 10 years, only they have changed this material only twice. Original plus one. So with the the money they spent for this. Our decision was correct. This is where I said, I told you that it seems that they don't care about the safety. But we gave them helmets, but they never used, and nothing has happened so far. because the same crowd, do the business, so they know how to erect it and dismantle it. That may be the reason. So this is how the roof covering is assembled. This is the main structure plus the side. Specifications of fabric, these were tested, the weight of the material, warp and weft, tensile strength, that is warp is, normally these fabric come in 1.2 meter rolls. So 1.2 meter, one yarn is coming from the one end to the other. It is the longitudinal direction. We call it warp. Warp is the cross yarn. Evil adi hatra 1.2. Cross yarn is always 1.2. Main yarn is length of the roll, 30 meter. Okay, naturally. In the longitudinal direction, strength is more. But unfortunately, we use it in the other direction. So you have to be very careful because we have used it in this direction. So for our strength calculations, we have to use weft tensile strength. I think you will understand what I say. And the elongation and the break and the oil test, UV protection and everything, but we did some this is a test report we got from Sri Lanka Institute of Textile and Apparel. It is I think at Moratuwa, where this is the sample, and we got this is Wope original 690. We of course they test material, the strength goes down. So they test for that. So we have to use this divided by 4 or some factor of safety and make sure that the material. These are the warp way and wet way, original and the after rub. So changing rooms and the other storeroom, control room, these are the places for the. So then only the mobile theater completes. These are the changing rooms for men and women on either side of the. This is where the changing rooms for males and females. So for advertising, their container they used as an advertising place, and the scaffolding 6 sets we have provided for erection. After erection, they used it for advertising. So this is the end to the presentation, and safety aspect, of course, one can argue that people are, according to new safety rules and regulations. Even the first principle of this ISL rules for in the professional engineer, as a professional engineer, you have to first and foremost consider about the safety aspect of the people. But the thing is that we have given them helmets, but the thing is we were not able to, even in our sites, construction sites still, it is very difficult for them to, you know, have a culture, a safety culture still at a, it is at a lower level, but I don't. So this is the client appreciation given to me, even it was given to our colleague Mr. Mahinda Jaikodi also, he also got this client appreciation. This I am showing you that they have completely satisfied with the answer that we have given them. Thank you very much.
I first experienced this about 2 days ago when this mobile kit was erected at the University of Lanka grounds.
Yeah.
And the day I went for the performance, it was that it was virtually sold out and it was raining. And I was there for the whole performance and it was just amazing. So congratulations on this. It's just fantastic. I was just wondering how much does the whole thing weigh, the entire
Very good question. You know that in containers, if you observe that there are few things marked on the back of the So definitely this is a light, you know that one factor that we considered in designing a mobile theater, every material should be lightweight, everything. That is why roofing we went for fabric, even steel tubes we used, not even only the doubles we used as the steel bars, otherwise you know the weight will go up. So we were very careful about selecting these lightweight materials. Definitely I cannot exactly answer your question how much it weighs. But it is not the full capacity of a 40-foot container, not even the half, I say. Whole thing won't weigh that much, no. Hundred foot by 80 foot, 100 by 80, about 8,000. Erection. After taking the load out from the container, you know that the container, we'll assume that traveling from Colombo, you go to the destination. We'll say it is morning, morning of a day. So they have to take out from the container. It will take about 3-4 hours, and you know that they have to keep it methodically. You can't just put the stuff. They have to keep it methodically. They have used to it, and it is about within one day. Next day evening they can start the show. So it is roughly 1.5 days. It is enough because they have used to it. Over and over again, same people are doing the same thing, so they are masters of that business.
You were talking of an alternative proposal that was.
Yeah, the proposal that I can't tell you the name of the company, but they came up with a different proposal in the sense that they still that document is with me. They came up with this PTFE material for the structure. And the structure also, you know that this structure cannot sustain with the PTFE material. PTFE material, you have to apply a huge tension so that that will have its shape. For the, they came up with a different alternative, but I didn't put that because we didn't consider, they didn't have money. Even the USA, frankly speaking, the preparation of the initial, the, you know, estimate was a big, big task for us, because you know that the no experience, but we gave an you know, estimate of 5 million at that time, but it went up to, because this was a design and build contract, so it went up to, if I can remember correct, mind, 5.8 or something. So we were very good in estimating 5.8. Actual cost was 5.8, but that 800,000 we had to bear, because this was a design and build contract. You can't talk. If you say this is the amount, you will have to sum a hook or crook, you have to design and do the job. That is not a civil engineer's job really. It is the architect who says that this space is enough. You know, in a lecture room also there is a norm. One point I can't remember exactly. In a theater, of course, 18 square meters means 1.8. I can't remember exactly the norm. There is a norm, 5 square meters per head, like. It is given in the Newford is the architectural Reynolds handbook. If I say there is an architectural Reynolds book, that is called Newford, everything is there. You get the page, it is there, this much of area for these people. So that, it is basically architect. That is why, you know, in the initial sketch he has prepared this much of area is required. He has never, I don't think that architect has this kind of arrangement. But it is the combined effort of all of us, the architect plus us plus the technicians who involved with the, you know, the fabricating, every branch, you know, the Vijayaratna was involved with this, one of our, you know, very prominent and very skilled craftsman, that all people's, you know, ideas came, you know, I come here and present it, but the thing is that I just wanted to tell you, the audience, that how you should, you know, that if you take that, now I am deviating from the main topic, you know, ඔය RD එක දැනට ලංකාවේ කරනවා road project, rural bridge project කියලා, bridges 7200ක් හදනවා. මේ අඩි 20-30 bridges. කවුද මේකේ ඇවිල්ලා මේ සල්ලි මේ bridges කොහෙන්ද design කරලා එවන්නේ? UK වලින් design කරන්නේ. මේ මා ලංකාවට design කරන්න බැරිද? මේ එක bridge එකකට සල්ලි කොච්චර යනවද? මේ රාජගිරිය bridge එකට කොච්චර සල්ලි ගියාද? මේ මේකෙන් ගහන්න බැරිද concrete bridges 10ක් අපිට? 5 million and 50 million says about that. So are we going to develop the country in this format? Or are we rely on ourselves and come up as a, you know, innovative people? I don't know how these institutions run, you know, that I am very proud to say that I am working in CECB, because this is a place for you to do this kind of thing. I don't think in anywhere you can practice this kind of thing. You will be out definitely. I know it. Oh, go around the hambe, yeah, and the killer, yeah, he let me turn over and the bag here. You know, I'm happy. No, it does not say, you know, that everything was analyzed in PROCON. You know that I didn't go up to that structural analysis part, you know, that this is a public lecture. You know, we must be very careful that the curiosity of the subject and the people must be taken to the presentation. Otherwise, you know, that if I put the, you know, the formulas and everything, there are tensile structures, there are formulas, some kind of formulas. Yeah. That is a different thing, you know, PROCON analysis. It is only for the steel structural framework design. That is very nominal. You know that design governance, it is a very nominal, you don't get these, you know, very, very thin elements. But the thing is, to handling purposes, you need to have some kind of size. Otherwise, you can have the design may says 10 millimeter, but for handling 10 millimeter will not be enough. So you'll have to naturally go for, so the design is, we say, what do you call that word? I can't exactly remember. Permissible design. Design is almost, you know, looked after, don't worry about the design. You know, the steel structure, the element selection and everything will looked after by the element sizing itself. But even though we have done it in proportion, don't worry about it. I never put the analysis part.
Thank you.
Good question. Yes.
I have one question. This again regarding this related about this about our engineers. Maybe I think you can always speak. We are talking about certain development and innovation. Are we on right track?
No.
How can change this one?
Yeah, I will answer, you know, very good question that I also wanted to speak in this line also. You know, where we do R&D work in our day-to-day practice, is CEB is doing, water board is doing, petroleum is doing any R&D type of work, and they publish, they may do it within their organizations and, you know, cut down some costs. As a layman, as a man in the country, that I have a right to you know, ask this. No, not everywhere this R&D you give a very minimal you know, concentration for R&D. Always try to, you know, do the routine type of work. But I don't believe that country should be at a developed stage to start R&D. You know, a country can become a developed stage only by doing R&D. You rely on yourself, you believe in yourself and do this kind of thing. You know that how much we have saved here? So this is for the country now ultimately. Like that, you know, that that should come from the, I don't think that you can't rely on the organizations. At least those who are present here, please go and, you know, start, but try to promote R&D, try to promote young engineers to think in a different angle. Otherwise, you know that this is at a very pathetic state.
How long did it take to design the whole
thing? It took about, good question again, because we didn't have any kind of material to read and everything. So it took about 1.5 years. But because it came with, evolved with the design, you know, changes and came up, ultimately the birth came after 1.5 years, like, you know, that you can't do it within, even though that it looks very flimsy, but it needs lot of thinking, you know. And the other thing that we were doing some other project, you know, we were constructing a drugstore building in IDH. At that time, parallel to that, we did this. That is why I said that this is an on the job R&D. Frankly speaking, not, but now I can give you an answer. You know that in the A-frame, because the support is A-frame, the main truss is supported there, and that is a pin end. Okay, so the failure, of course, has to be there. The failure modes, we never thought, frankly speaking, never. Mind that. Singhalinga, Daulak, Nemik, Grisimaki, like a Nanya, Peter, මේක තියෙන්නේ අපිට අදහස් ප්‍රකාශ කර ගැනීමේ ප්‍රශ්නයක් නේ තියෙන්නේ ඉතින් ඒක අවුලක් නේ because he is the man who was right behind me as engineering assistant from the beginning. Kiyan singala kiyan avulak ne.
Eke ara ekmanta ekama story ga. Eke ekrawa
singa kiyala
usanne. Mai
මයික් එකටම මයික් එකටම කතා කරන්නේ නැත්නම් හරියට ඇහෙන්නේ නැහැ කැඩි කැඩි. කියන්නේ කියන්නේ ඕනම තැනක බේස් ප්ලේට් එක ෆ්ලෙක්සිබල් අපි කරේ බේස් ප්ලේට් එක. මොකද ගිහිල්ලා අපි දන්නේ නැහැ මොන තැනක තියන්න වෙයිද කියලා මේක. ඒක නිසා කොලම් එකට වෙනම බෙයරින් එකක් සෙට් කරගෙන මේ මෙහෙම මේ අපිට මේක උඩ පල්ලෙය ඒ කියන්නේ එයා සෙට් වෙලා ගන්නට කෙලින් වෙලා හිටිනවා. එහෙම එහෙම අපෝ දැන් තමයි මට ඒක මතක වෙන්නේ වැදගත් ඩීටේල් එකක් ඇත්තට. අතන
දැන් සිටින එකේ මොනවද සිටින එක නැති කරා කියන මොනවද කියන්නේ
It was not for profit making, it was for just for engineering, you know, appreciation. We like, you know, that it is not the salary that motivates us, it is this kind of engineering. This is why we say that most of the people still they work in CECB because of this culture is there. I don't know about the other places. Other places they have high salaries, I know. In CECB, boat about petroleum, everywhere you take more than what we get. But why we are satisfied with what we do. So this kind of thing we can do. Even oil exploration, you tell, we will do it tomorrow. ඒක කියවලා කරලා this is where the engineering අපි ඉන්නේ engineering practice කරන්න නේද එතකොට ඉතින් මේක කාට හරි පිටරට ගෙනත් බාර දීලා හරියන්නේ නැහැ engineering කරන්න කියලා අපි මෙහෙ බලාගෙන ඉඳලා අපි කරන්නේ මොනවද design verification ආ design check කර කර ඉඳලා හරියන්නේ නැහැ නේ අපි design කරන්න එපා
Thank you very much, Engineer Karunaretne. First of all, I would like to invite our senior engineer, Engineer Gamini Silva, to hand over the token of appreciation to Engineer Karunaretne. Could you please come to the audience podium to hand over this word of Ingani. Thank you, Engineer Gamini, and thank you, Engineer U.S. Karunaretne. Actually, I want to highlight one thing. Engineer U.S. was a good guy. Was giving me a good job. Believed the good name. Ultimately, you got that. පොත් ගොඩක් තියෙනවා මේ ස්කෙචස් ගොඩක් තියෙනවා ලියපු නෝට්ස් ගොඩක් තියෙනවා that was the secret actually this kind of thing so I would like to invite to do many many things and serve our engineers and serve the country more many more and we are waiting for your feedbacks guidance to in more in future with that I would like to thanks to all to participate this event and this will already broadcast online and there will be YouTube audio video also will be available and anytime you can visit that one and I would like to tell about one thing about our civil engineer sectional committee we are this year we are trying to do some more things and as example end of this month we are planning Actually, before 2 weeks ago, we had a good lecture with Professor Ranavir about our ancient technology. And end of this month, we are planning to visit some ancient places and with some resource personnel like that. And there will be some more workshops and public lectures. And this time, we are going to do one CSR activity also. Many, many activities will be there. So I would like to invite you all to participate, not only as participants, Anytime you can come to join the committee and work with some subcommittee and there's a good opinion to serve to engineers and serve the country. Thank you very much and have a fantastic evening. Thanks.